Where did it go?
Let me introduce the management committee members of our association. Professor Mr. B.V. Srinivas Gupta, Vice President. Vargavi Pandit Madam, Honorary Secretary. Sri O. Pratap Kumar, Joint Secretary. Sri R.K. Bharat Sir, Member and CEO. Anupama Pandit, Administrative Officer. Ashok Chanai, Member Deputy.
After that, we will move to the departments. All the department head, and you have departments of coordinators.
Yes.
First, from here, we'll go to the library.
Okay.
From here, we'll go to the library, and by the time, during this period, all the HODs are sitting here, they will move to their respective departments.
Okay.
And they will prepare, and after visiting library, there will be the two groups, A group and B groups. A group will be visiting to some department, B will be visiting to some departments. And all these activities will be finished very well.
Yeah.
And after that, there will be some activities which is proposed here, and that will be carried out after this. And from 2 to 3 o'clock, like 3 o'clock, 3 to 3:30, interaction with the students. And this is already fixed, and we have already informed the students.
Yeah.
There is no restricting in this. And 3:30 to 4 o'clock, interaction with the alumni and parents. We have already informed to all parents.
Yes.
And the 4 o'clock to the 5 o'clock, discussion among the team members. That we will have a discussions in the IQAC office. All the discussion will be made in the IQAC office, and your office is there.
Yes, sir.
And there will also discussion about your IQAC activities.
Okay.
With all supporting documents.
Okay.
And from 5 to 5:30, there will be a culture program. The culture program will be
auditorium,
and that will be a culture program organized by the students. All participants will be from your institute.
Yes,
students.
All students.
Yeah. And after that, 5:30.
That's fine. So, what I understand is that IQAC presentation will take place the afternoon,
yes,
from 4 to 5 p.m.
Okay.
And during that presentation and after interaction with IQAC team, we will have some discussion about that. So, right now, we will just have an institute level overview and presentation. after 45 minutes reading of a library visit. Then after doing library at 11 o'clock, we will all split.
So our institute comes under the umbrella of a Gita Shishikshana Sangha, started in 1975, situated in Siddhartha Nagar, Mysore. Association started by late Professor B.S. Pandit sir, who has worked as physics professor in SJSC Mysore, which is currently known as JSS Science and Technology University. He has been in the teaching profession for more than 30 years. Because of his vision, initiation and dedication, this association was started. And these are the founders, Shri Kata S. Pandit and Srimati Rukmini S. Pandit, parents of Professor B.S. Pandit. And our past presidents are late Shri B.K. Kenche Gowda and Shri M. Anand Rao. These are the present management committee member, Dr. M. Jagannathane as president, Srimati Vanjavi Pandit as honorary secretary, Shri B.V. Srinivas Gupta as vice president, Shri O. Pratap Kumar as joint secretary, Ratnamma Kenche Gowda as founder member, Shri Ashok Chana as member, Shri B.K. Nataraj as member, Shri R.K. Bharathar as member and CEO. These are the other institutes being run by our association. And our institution, the GSS Institute of Engineering and Technology for Women, was started in the year 2003 and is affiliated to Visheshwarya Technological University, named after the Bharat Ratna Saram Visheshwarya. And this institute is housed in the campus of 11.55 acres and it's having four blocks. And these are the institutions being run by our institution. These are the courses being run by our institution. We have six UG programs. And out of six UG programs, five UG programs are accredited by NBLU Delhi. And in 2019, telecommunication engineering with an intake of 60 is merged with electronics and communication engineering. And as a result, the intake of ENC from 2019 is 180. In addition to these UG branches, we have two MTech programs in computer science and engineering and digital communication networking, each with an intake of 18. And we also run Master of Business Administration at MBA with an intake of 120, having specialization in marketing, finance, and HR. We also offer dual specialization in the company. And these are institution core values. Our objective is to achieve women empowerment through value-based technical education. So we will come to the salient features of the institute. Our institute is the first women engineering college in the state of Karnataka, and it's the first non-autonomous engineering institute to get accredited by NBLU Delhi in Mysore region. And we have established NALABU Academy School in association with National Instruments in 2019. So we have procured 30 users of LabVIEW software and hardware like MyDAC, Pyrio and other things. And after procuring that, they have trained our faculty and students, and five of our faculty members are cleared the CLAD exam, and two students also cleared CLAD exam. Upon the completion of the CLAD exam, our institute is awarded with the LabVIEW Academy School, and our faculty members have become authorized trainers. And after they become authorized trainers, they have trained our students on LabVIEW Core 1 and 2 software. And our institute is recognized as host institute by MSME Government of India, New Delhi. And our institute is having the Institution Innovation Council as per the guidelines of MHRD Innovation Cell. And our institute is awarded with Silver College rating for QSIGET methodology by QSRA Private Limited in 2019. And our institute profile and achievement. And as I told, our institute is recognized as host institute by MSME Government of India, New Delhi. And benefits of the MSME Incubation Center is that it uses funds for conducting the awareness program and workshop. It provides financial support up to 1 crore for procurement and installation of machine, that is infrastructure development. And it provides seed capital up to 1 crore for the startups which are going to establish in our institute. And it also supports up to 15 lakhs for each of the idea being implemented by various companies in our institute, and every year they support up to 10 ideas. And since they support up 10 ideas every year, in order to motivate and create a platform for students, we have conducted an idea competition called as Entrepreneurna. And in this competition, students of our institute have presented 21 ideas, and 7 ideas, and for this competition we have invited the industry experts as the jury members, and out of the 21 ideas, 7 ideas have been selected and forwarded to the MSME Incubation Center. And MSME Incubation Center is also having the selection committee, local selection committee consists of the members from MSME, industry experts and academic experts. And out of the 7, 4 are selected for proof of concept regional mentoring by industrial experts available in Mysuru. On behalf of GSSSIETW, we have submitted 22 ideas for Smart India Hackathon organized by MHRD, Government of India. And this is the certificate of the MHRD Innovation Cell. And these are some of the activities being organized by the Innovation Cell. And this provides a platform for our institute to carry out innovative projects and to provide the necessary facilities for preparing for the various hackathons. These are some of the activities conducted by the Institution Innovation Council. And for both the Institution Innovation Council and the Incubation Center, Dr. Raviraj is the IQSC Director and Professor in Computer Science Engineering is the coordinator. And these are the glimpses of some of the activities, some of the hackathons being participated by our students. We also have the entrepreneurship development cell to impart entrepreneurship skills to the students to create entrepreneurship culture in the campus. And we are receiving a grant of 1 lakh from the Department of Science and Technology since 2017 to organize the entrepreneurship awareness camp with a resource person from Entrepreneurship Development Institute, Ahmedabad, and the India Startups Bangalore. And every year we are funded with the 1 lakh rupees to conduct 5 awareness camps, and this we are doing from 2017. And this is the letter indicating the grant. And these are the glimpse of some of the activities being organized by the EDCSL. Dr. Padma Shri is a professor in Electronics and Communication Department. She is the in charge of the EDCSL. And also conduct the open learning program under the EDC cell, and it's an year-long program wherein the classes are conducted in the weekends by the resource person from EDI Gujarat and India Startups Bangalore. And at the end of the 1 year program, they are going to conduct the qualifying exam, and those who are clear the qualifying exam, they are eligible to apply for funding from the Department of Science and Technology up to 1.5 crores so that they can become the student entrepreneurs. And 28 students and 2 faculties of our institute have completed the open learning program in the qualifying examination. And we also conduct social activities under the NSSL. These are the glimpses of certain social activities we have conducted under the NSSL. And our students not only perform well in the academics, they also perform excellently in sports arena. These are the glimpses of the sports participation by our students. And these are some of the major achievements of our students in the sports arena. They have won VTO Rest of Bangalore Volleyball Tournament, and they have got silver and bronze medal in the National Ice Skating Championship, and they have performed well in Kabaddi Tournament, Throwball Tournament, and the Handball Tournament. And these are the sports achievers for institute. When you come to the research activities, see, our faculty members have secured a grant up to 1.1 crore rupees. And myself, I got 30 lakhs rupees from the Department of Science and Technology, VTHT, Government of Karnataka, on the establishment of the state-of-art robotics lab. And Dr. Meenakshi Sundaram has got a grant of 30 lakhs from the VTHT, Government of Karnataka, for setting up IoT laboratory. And Dr. Reshma Bamu has got the 5 lakh rupees grant from VTHT for under the scheme Seed Money to Young Scientists for Research. And Dr. Jayant has got a grant of rupees 10 lakh from Department of Science and Technology. And this year, Dr. Vinay Venugopal has got a grant of 30 lakhs from VGST Government of Karnataka. And Dr. Raviraj has got 5 lakhs from VGST Government of Karnataka. These are the glimpses of the facility that is created under the VGST grant. And our institute is associated with the E-Yantra team of IIT Bombay and Robotic Research Lab at IIIT Hyderabad. And based on the facilities created, four faculty members are pursuing research in the area of robotics. And our students have done quite a number of important projects in the area of robotics. These are the glimpses of the works being carried out by the institute using the facility available in the robotics lab. And as I told, we have got 30 lakhs for setting up IoT laboratory. These are the facilities available in the IoT laboratory and glimpses of the activities conducted using the facility created. And we have conducted so far 4 international conferences, 3 international conferences under IEEE and 1 under Springer. And these are the keynote speakers. For these 3 IEEE international conferences, Dr. Parmeshachari, Professor and Head of Telecommunication Department, is the publication chair. Dr. Reshma Bano, organizing chair for these 3 conferences. She is the Professor and Head of Information Science and Engineering. And keynote speakers are Vishnu Pendala from USA and Dr. Sanjeev Sujio from Mauritius in 2016 and 2017. Chin Kon Ho from Malaysia and Metesky Lenoid and Archil Marshall from Russia, and in 2018 Subalakshmi Kher from USA and T.O. Youngman from Singapore and Dr. Banu Prakash from Singapore. These are the keynote speakers. And the details of the number of papers received, accepted, and the affiliation of the authors from various countries and the glimpses of the activities conducted in the conferences. And we also conducted an international seminar using the keynote speakers came for 2018 IEEE International Conference. And this is the Springer International Conference conducted in 2019. And Dr. Meenakshi Sundaram, Professor and Head Department of Computer Science and Engineering, was the organizing chair. And Dr. Joseph Emerson Raja from Malaysia. And Professor Shin Ming Chen from Taiwan. Dr. C.P. Gupta from IIT Roorkee, they were the keynote speakers. These are the glimpses of the events conducted under the Springer International Conference. And the details of the number of papers accepted, received, accepted, and the authors, the countries of the authors who have participated in this conference. And to create a platform for the faculties and students to apply for patents, we have established the IPR cell, and this gives awareness to the faculties and students what is intellectual property, how it can be filed, what are the advantages. Those awareness will be given, and for that we have invited Dr. M.N. Bhimesh, who is the Honorary Director, National Institute of Advanced Legal Studies, and is a senior advocate. We have conducted several activities under the IPR cell. And we have association with various professional societies. We have IEEE student branch in our institute. Dr. Parmeshachari, Professor and Head of Telecommunication Department, is the IEEE student branch counselor. These are the activities conducted under the IEEE student branch. And we have association with IST and activities conducted under IST. Some of the activities, glimpses of activities. And we have association with Computer Science, Computer Society of India, that is both CS and IS department. See, our institute is, our CSA chapter is adjudged as the best CSA chapter in the state of Karnataka in 2016 and 17. And both the ENC and telecommunication department are associated with the IIT student chapter, and also we have the college level IIT chapter also. And we have the electronics and instrumentation department is associated with the Instrumentation Society of India, whose head office is located in IAAC Bangalore. And our institute is a member of the Information System Security Association chapter, and its activity conducted under the ISSA. And we have research centers in 10 departments, that is all the 6 engineering departments and 4 basic science departments, physics, chemistry, maths. And we have the guides in all the research centers, and 27 research scholars are pursuing their PhD program under our research center. And we have association with some of the leading industries. And these are some of the industries with which our institute has signed MOU. And these are the technical collaborations with the various industries in the over the years. And we have total 115 faculty members, 19 faculty members are having PhD and 42 are pursuing PhD and 54 are having M.Tech degree. And average teaching experience of the faculties working in our institute is 9.1 years. And our faculty members have published 159 journals, published papers in 159 journals, 294 papers in conferences. And our faculty members, five faculty members are worked as BOE, BOS and academic senate in various universities.
This is the data for last how many years?
The assessment year.
Current.
Only for 1 year?
No, this is for the current year.
The data of papers published?
For past 5 years.
Past 5 years. Because NAAC generally does your assessment for 5 years. 5 years. So, 159 papers, books published in journals is for last 5 years.
Yes.
And 294 is for the last
five years.
And if you go back to the previous slide, 164 are active collaborations.
Activities.
With the help of MOU, we have conducted activities.
In 1 year, 2017 and 18.
In various departments, all together.
So, in 2017 and 18, there was a major surge in the activities. But before that, it was around 33 and 24. Because that was when you got the NBA.
Yes.
So, you were expecting NBA visits, so there was a sudden surge in activities, and before that,
maybe we can say that is where we started improving on so many areas.
But out of 365 days, 164 activities were conducted only in 1 year, 2017-18.
Different departments,
not that
so, how much time was spent on teaching?
It was every Saturday, you know, we dedicated only for these such kind of activities. And
but there are 52 weeks in a year.
Yeah, six departments now.
Six.
So every Saturday,
we used to
six engineering departments and MBA department.
And there were no minor exams and no summer vacations and no.
No, they were there. They were there.
But 52 weeks in a year. And without any summer vacation and winter vacation. You were working, doing activities on every weekend?
Every weekend there were activities.
So the students were not given any summer vacation?
No, they used to have that vacation break, ma'am.
But they did not go out of Mysore.
Yes.
They all stayed here. They were from different states. Like
they went to the examination, they will go.
They get about 3 weeks of time.
Because I can't see this 164 justification. If you can produce
we'll
be very happy.
Yes, yes.
Each department we are maintaining event.
I think this includes conducting expert talk in the department.
Yes. Workshops, seminars,
all together.
So all these activities.
It is all available.
And 12 faculty members have worked as resource person and session chairs in various conferences. And Dr. Rajendra Patil, professor and head of EC department, has filed a patent recently. And a few of our faculty members have got the overseas exposure. Dr. Vinay Venugopal, who is professor and head of physics department, has done his PhD in Welft University of Technology, Netherlands, and he has done his postdoctoral research. The University of Waterloo, Canada, and Dr. Venkatratham Chitore is the HOD of E&I department, has worked as senior lecturer at Asia Pacific University, Malaysia, and has done the PhD in the same country. And Dr. Parmeshwacharya and Dr. Jayan were invited as session chair in the international conference held at Malaysia. And myself and Mr. Srinivas Rao have worked as subject expert in the EduSat program. It's an e-learning program wherein the program on some subject was telecasted throughout the affiliating colleges, and that was viewed by the students taking that particular course. And these are the student achievements. Our students have published 125 papers, attended 123 workshops, conducted in our institute and elsewhere. And 415 students have attended the internship, and 15 students have attended the hackathon. We have various clubs in our institute, and so many student projects are funded by the Karnataka State Council on Science and Technology, Vision Group on Science and Technology under the TRIP scheme, and funding from the affiliating university BTU. And our students have got several awards, and Aisha Kalam of Computer Science Department has secured a gold medal in the NDRF design competition held in 2018. Similarly, Maitri of EEE department has got bronze medal under the electronics and electrical and electronic discipline in 2018. And these are glimpses of the participation of students in various cultural activities. See, our students have participated in the they have performed a drama called the Mari Kadu in the Navaratri, that is Dasara region, Dasara time in the Kalamandira in 2008, that is last year. And these are the some of the outreach program we participated. This is what we are following as a part of curriculum planning and implementation. And we are following the lesson plan and the course-wise notes, which is going to be available in the institute server and the college ERP before the beginning of the semester. And we are going to conduct the parent-teachers meeting frequently, at least once in a month, so that to disseminate the performance of the student to the parents. And at the end of each test, we are going to disseminate the performance of the student and the attendance position to their parents through the message to their mobile. And we also conduct several training programs, that is soft skill aptitude training and replacement training under the training and placement cell. And in order to bridge the gap between the curriculum and industry requirement, we conduct various add-on courses, workshops, and technical talks. And we take the feedback whenever we conduct any of the programs from the student. And we offer the subject to the faculty members based on their specialization. And we always believe in upgradation of the faculty by deputing the faculty to the various workshops and the faculty development program. And as a part of the university curriculum, we follow the choice-based credit system. We have two types of electives being offered in our curriculum. That is open elective, wherein the student from any department can take a particular elective, and professional elective, where the subjects of that particular branch can be taken as elective by the students.
And this has been offered by BTU?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
BTU has given you the choice, the flexibility of CBCS, open elective.
We are following, since our is affiliated university, we follow the curriculum prescribed by the BTU. And this is regarding the curriculum gap analysis process. And the BTU curriculum will be revised once in 4 years. And once we receive the curriculum from the BTU, we are going to take the feedback from various stakeholders. And that is reviewed in the department level program assessment committee. And they are going to identify the gap. And once the gap exists in the curriculum, what we are going to do is, in order to fill the gap that is created, we are going to conduct various add-on courses, that's in terms of workshops, training, skill development program, internship, and industrial visit. Our students visit at least one industry every year, that is every semester, so that they got the better industrial exposure. And also we send our suggestions regarding the modifications to be made in the syllabus to the Board of Studies.
And you have implemented AICTE model curriculum?
Yes, sir.
Implemented.
Yes, sir.
Since 2018,
yes, sir.
You are following all.
Yes, sir.
So this
we are following as per the guidance of the
CBCS system.
Yes, sir.
CBCS system, it is already implemented by you, though this is ICT model curriculum.
Yes, sir. We are following the ICT model curriculum.
And now you are following the ICT model curriculum.
Yes, sir.
So this is the ICT model curriculum. In what way you are implementing the CBCS system? It is based on the open elective standards, which is in integration the existing scheme.
Yes. Yes. And these are some of the add-on courses conducted by various departments. And as a co-curricular activity, as I told, we conduct these activities to fill the gap between the curriculum and the industry requirement. And we take the feedback from various stakeholders like student, faculty, alumni, and the parents. And these are the actions we have taken on the curriculum. That is, we conduct certificate courses, remedial coaching for the slow learners, and we motivate the fast learners. We motivate them to take quality projects, participate in various hackathons, various competitions, and also we motivate them to register for the MOOC courses. And many students have registered for the MOOC courses, and even the faculties, and many of them have cleared the MOOC courses conducted by reputed organizations.
While conducting the remedial courses, remedial classes for the BT students, have you recorded the transcendent improvement in the transcendent?
Yes, sir. And these are the department wise admission details over the year. And this is the admission
data. Go back to the previous slide, please. So the sanctioned intake for CSC is 120. And for EC it is also 120.
20 months. Till the last year. This year it is 108.
Okay. I'll just take one.
And these are admission details. This admission details category wise. And regarding the teaching learning process, we follow the academic calendar prescribed by the university, and we follow the ICD, ICT mode teaching. We follow the adopt the e-learning, that is e-shikshana, and the MOOC courses, co-curricular activity for the holistic development, continuous evaluation and the examination and evaluation. That is, as per the university norms, we need to conduct 3 tests for all the theory subjects, and we do the continuous evaluation in the practical subjects.
But that is prescribed by
yes,
CQ.
Yes, it is.
And study material is what?
Study material means we provide the course notes in the college server, and also we give the course material from the NPTEL, so many online courses in the digital library available in our institute. They can refer those study materials, and we are going to do the mentoring with the help of the counseling for both the slow learners and the fast learners.
Have you allocated any grades to MOOC courses?
Yes, sir. Now, see, we don't have the provision to allocate credit because it is affiliated.
So then how do you ensure that MOOC is
We take the certificate for the registration, and we during the counseling, we know what subject they have registered, what they have learned. Those things we have found out with the help of the counseling.
So every department
yes,
have
yes.
some
We have the details.
Related.
We have the details. And these are the different methods of learning being adopted. Our institute, experimental learning, participative learning, problem solving, and student diversity. And these are the activities conducted under various type of learning modalities. And so we do the evaluation process for the internal assessment test. We set the paper, and it's going to be reviewed by the review committee consisting of head of the department, senior faculty in the department, and one external member. They are going to review the question paper, and they are going to suggest for the modification. Once those modifications are implemented, then they take the final printout of the test question paper, scheme of evaluation is prepared, evaluated, and the evaluation is done within 1 week of the conduction of the test, and results are disseminated to the students on the notice board, and they can meet personally the faculty, and it's disseminated to the parents through the message on their mobile and through the college level ER.
But this is for the minor exams.
Minor exams, yes.
And internal assessment is done 100% by the your own staff. So there's no question paper setting common to all affiliated colleges or
no.
Earlier, I think there used to be a common test paper also.
No.
Only for the final exam. Are you observing that examination reforms, essentially examination reforms, at least at the internal level?
Okay.
Are you following this? No. You have not applied
examination reforms. No, it's at the university level, it's at the process of finalizing.
Might not have implemented so far, but at least at the internal level, at the institute level, you can have to implement.
Okay, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And regarding the CAE, that is the internal test, any grievance first it will be addressed by the faculty, then further level will be done by the HOD part. And regarding the university level examination, but the approach the faculty, then HOD. And if any grievance are there, it is reported to the university through the principal. And these are the reforms we are adopting, that is the provision for the replacement or the retest for those who miss the test on medical grounds and those who represent the institute for some activity. And the weightage will be given for assignments, seminars and the project. As I told earlier, it is evaluation is done within a week. And we are going to display the scheme of evaluation and notice board to know how they should have written the internal test. And these are the various committees available in our institute. And details of the members of various committees and their contact information will be available in our college website, and also we put it on the department notice. And this is how we adopt the attainment, have both direct and indirect attainment, 60% direct attainment and 40% indirect attainment. And regarding the PAO and PSO attainment, direct attainment is 8% and 40%, that is 40 marks for the IA and 60 marks for the final examination. And we conduct the various surveys like graduate exit survey, alumni survey and employer survey. And this is how we get the attainment, the CO attainment and both the IA and university level examination. Regarding the research and consultancy, in order to encourage the development of both the student and the faculty, our institute, the management has allocated up to 1 lakh rupees for the development of the departmental activities, for conducting various activities in the department and participation of the students and faculty in various activities. And these are the activities conducted for the student development and the faculty development. And we also, management has waived 20% tuition fee waiver for the in-house faculties who are pursuing their research in our research centers. And these are the glimpses of various ISR activities. And we have the Ranger and Rover. And we conduct various programs to train our students on the self-defense techniques. Our students have taken the karate training and won several prizes in the competitions, karate competitions held outside. And our institute is going to conduct some social activities in terms of computer training to nearby government schools and in the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Our institute is the member of Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. We conduct several social activities under the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. We adopted 5 villages to conduct various awareness programs and social activities under the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. These are the various physical infrastructure available in our institute. These are the glimpses of physical infrastructure. And we have the girls hostel within the campus. The girls hostel can accommodate up more than 400 students. It's having 4 blocks. For each block, there's a dedicated warden to monitor the day-to-day activities. And these are the details of the warden and the assistant warden, and some facilities available in the hostel. And as a part of the hostel day celebration, we conduct several cultural programs so that the students of the hostel, students who are staying in the hostel, feel at home. And these are the details of the library facilities available in the library. We are the members of VTO consortium, and as a result we have the Turnitin plagiarism software, legal version of the Turnitin plagiarism software. It will be useful for testing the quality of the paper before it being published in various conferences and journals. And we have the members for various e-resources like Springer, Taylor and Francis, ProQuest, Kimbers and ACSE. And we have 38,087 books and 6,144 titles. We have various printed journals also. We have the easily facility for effective transaction of the books within the library. And these are the IT infrastructure. Our institute is having the Wi-Fi facility with a speed of more than 100 Mbps. We have 38 smart classrooms. And we have IT-enabled accounts and establishment and admission section. We have the paperless office. And our institute is having the ERP facility. And we have IT-enabled library access system. We have 785 desktops, 39 printers, and we have 60 Wi-Fi access points. And these are the details regarding the maintenance of campus infrastructure. And the classroom laboratories, they are maintained by the instructors and foremen of respective departments similarly. And the other facilities are maintained by the corresponding people for effective usage of the infrastructure available in our institute. Regarding the student progression, our institute is doing well in terms of campus placement, and our students have been placed in various reputed companies. And last year, 303 students have been placed in reputed companies with the highest package of 10.7 lakhs from VMware. And in the same company, more 18 students of the institute is already working, which is the highest among the engineering colleges present in and around Mysore. And this year already 229 offers have been given to the our students in the 2020 outgoing batch. Accenture has taken 108. The other companies, major companies, visited Juniper Networks, SAP, TCS, Mindtree, and so many companies have recruited our students within the span of 1 month. And many more companies are in the pipeline, both in this semester and the next semester. This is a glimpse of the various recruiters and the group photo of the students who are placed in the last year. That is in 2019. And this is the student progression detail, that is the results of the students in various branches over the years. And our institute, the students have secured 18 ranks so far in the university examination. And this year we got, that is in 2018 outgoing batch, we have got 3 ranks, 1 in UG and 2 in PG. And regarding the student progression, generally 10% of the students go for higher studies. And more than 60% of the students are placed through the on-campus placement drive, and 10% through the off-campus placement drive, 5% will go for the teaching, and 5% will go for the government and corporate services. And these are the financial assistance given to the various students of our institute through the various government and non-government scholarship schemes. And our institute has established the scholarship to the meritorious students under the Geeta Chaitanya scheme from 2016, wherein 100 students are given scholarship of 10,000 each every year. And these are the details of the glimpses of the Geeta Chaitanya Merit Scholarship scheme. That is, in first year, top 25 seat rank holders. In the next 3 years, based on the meritorious level of the students and the economic level, they are awarded with 10,000 rupees cash prize. And founders of the one of the founders of our institute, Sima Silkar, they have established the scholarship for college topper. That is the silver plaque worth half a kg from the last 2 years. And this is a glimpse of the activities of scholarship scheme under the Sima Silk Memorial Award of Excellence. And we conduct the alumni meet in order to have effective interaction of alumni with the students and the departments of our institute. And we conduct the alumni meet in the second Saturday of May every year. In addition to that, we conduct the project symposium every year. In that project symposium, final year students are going to present their papers based on the work carried out in the final year. And for that, we are going to call the industry alumni as the jury members, so that they get the industry trends and better suggestions regarding their project work. And also, there will be alumni interaction. And alumni, they visit our institute once in a while, and they are going to address the students with the help of the motivational talk and the technological advances. These are some of the activities conducted under the alumni meet. Regarding the governance, leadership and management, see our institute vision is to become the provide value-based technical education, women empowerment through the value-based technical education, and these are the missions of our institute to achieve the vision. This organization structure of our institute. This academic governing council. B.V. Rao as the chairman, Dr. K.R.S. Murthy, Prof. M.A. Chandrasekhar, Ramakrishna Rao, Shyam Devasudev Rao, Anand Bhatt, Srimati S. Pratap, Sridhar as members, and for management we have Mr. Anupama Pandit as a member, and as an industry from the as alumni member we have Mauna Maunappa and Archana Muralidhar. And we always, our institute always believed in decentralization and participative management, and these are the activities, is how we support the decentralization and the participative management.
Delegation of power at HOD level is there?
Yes, sir.
How much?
And always, that will come to that, sir. Regarding the recruitment, the HODs are involved, and even the budget preparation, the HODs are taken into confidence.
Have you given them some fancy power to HOD?
Yes, sir. That is, they are going to allocate the special budget fund up to 1 lakh. The HODs have the power to utilize that fund.
Complete budget of the department is prepared by the head of the department, and that is approved by the board of management. And they have the freedom of asking whatever they like.
They have the freedom of spending those money by inviting some experts.
Yes. For student and the faculty development and the department development. Regarding the governance, we have the service rules, CS and R policies, recruitment and promotional policies, budget planning, allocation and utilization, and we have welfare scheme like the gratuity, group insurance for staff and student, PF and ESI facility. We have the leave facility as per the KCSR rules, and providing flexible working hours for faculty pursuing PhD, and 20% fee waiver for in-house faculty pursuing PhD in our research center. And this is regarding the financial management and budget preparation. The budget will be prepared by the various departments, and that is forwarded to the principal, and principal will scrutinize the budget that is submitted by various departments. And after scrutinization, it is submitted to the management. Management will go through that and prepare the consolidated budget, and it's placed before the BOG for approval. And once it is approved, it is delivered to the departments for the utilization.
What is the fee structure, annual fee structure of students?
From CET, the government students, from the centralized counseling, they pay around last 5 years, I would say it is between 65,000 to 75,000 now. It got increased 5%, 8%, something like that. And the Comet K, there is another 30% of the seats is done by the Comet K. So Comet K, they fixed fees from 1.5 lakhs to 1.7 lakhs. That is the range they fix. But only for the top branches, the computer science and electronics, people pay 1.5 lakhs. It is a consortium of engineering and medical
association of private colleges, and under that association,
yeah,
they allocate engineering and medical.
50% are through government.
Yeah,
yes.
So what happens is, actually technically 45% from the government, 30% from Comet K. That is association, management association, and last 25% belongs to the management.
And the exam that is conducted is by the state government or JEIITG?
State government. For the government quota seat, state government conducts the examination. then they declare the ranks.
What about remaining 30%, 25%?
30% also they conduct an examination. The association
separate
two separate
Karnataka examination
that is separate.
Yeah.
And then what is the government, government conducts another examination?
That is KEMA. 45% of the seats, Karnataka Examination Authority.
Okay.
So they conduct the examination for the 45% of the seats. For 35% of the seats is the Association of the Private Managements. They conduct, that is Comet K. And management, you know, we have to give away seats to the students who have got the rank of either in Comet K or in
seat.
That is KEMA.
But then that is on a different fee structure?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay.
So almost Comet K, that is the association fees, and the management fees is almost the same. It is 1.5 lakhs.
Around 1.5.
Yes, yes.
And government seats are between 65,000.
Yeah. And in our case, what happens is, since it's an exclusively women's college, we don't get students from Comet K. The 30% of the seats, in that we normally surrender 20% of the seats to the Comet. So, last, if you see the trend, we spill about 60 to 65% of the seats from the government fees only. Only the 25% seats, we are able to fill up only 20% and the management. So, we close somewhere around 80-85% admissions. So, we have only two categories technically, that is one is the government, 65% government seats.
But through government, you must be getting good students.
We are getting good students.
Although at a low prior fee. But yeah, the quality of students,
yeah,
they must be high ranking.
Yes.
Yes, yes. That is actually reflecting in our...
But all India level you get students?
Not much, ma'am. It's maximum 90% is from Karnataka.
Karnataka, because many people from other states do not take Karnataka
as
admission.
They come, they stop in Bangalore. They don't move to Mysore. Their preference is to, you know,
to take
to be in...
You are following all the resolution also?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah. Even in the management seats also you follow these or not?
Management, there is no policy, sir. There is no reservation at the management seats.
In both, whether it is a Comet K and management,
yeah.
There is no reservations.
Yeah, Comet K also there is no reservation.
The government, for 45% share, you have to observe the resolution.
Yes.
And then if you are unable to fill them, then you convert them for general category?
Yeah, it gets converted into general category, and finally in the third round of counseling, they all you know, give away as general merit seats.
We have the internal audit system by the department staff and the accounts officer, and we have external audit by the chartered accountant, the Madhavan & Co. And the audit report is usually handled. And these are the members of IPAC, that Raghuraj as director and myself. Chairman of the IPAC and
constituted as per UGC norms?
As per NAAC standards.
Okay, then we can start some interaction with the HODs as well, so that we can finish the right by the chair.
Okay, thank
How many weeks they go for? How many weeks?
Four weeks.
4 weeks. After the completion of the odd semester.
Six semesters.
After the completion of the six semester, they to go for the 4 weeks. How they will be able to complete the 14 to 20 weeks as per
For that, the seventh semester class will start bit late, as per the university guidelines only. And there is a provision to complete the internship in two stages, one at the end of 6th and remaining duration at the end of 7th. There is a provision made by the university.
The terms, even if you start after completion of first year, second year and third year. Mm-hmm. After first year, students can go for 4 weeks, second year 4 weeks.
We are insisting the university to conduct the internship early so that they will be free for the placement at the end of the 6th semester.
Total of 8 weeks, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What about the equity action plan? Have you implemented the equity action plan with those child, those girls child who are not going to be and bigger sections? Have you implemented some kind of scheme for them, for their equipment? For example, about the, say, the weak students, you have got all the ramp and everything for these?
Yes, sir. Just a bit.
Yeah, yeah.
We have, sir.
For this slide, ramp, okay.
For disabled persons, we cover.
Switch chair is also.
And there's a prohibition for stripes in the university examination.
You have not discussed anything about the gate training. What kind of gate training provided by?
Yes, sir. We provide the.
What is the outcome that how many gate students are able to qualify the gate score?
See, that detail, that number is less. Number of students who qualify gate, but only, as I told, only 10% of the students go for the higher studies. Many of them prefer the recruitment through the on campus or the off campus.
Do you have any startup policy? Institute in startup policy?
That's what, sir. See, we have the MSME incubation cell. MSME incubation cell, we are encouraging the startups. And also, already two startups have approached us. And already we have prepared the policy. Shortly, they are going to be in the campus.
Any financial transactions with them that you have supported them or they have?
That's what. As soon as the policy is framed, they will be moved over to campus.
The
Already under the MSME, two companies already told. One company is already selected by the selection committee. One company is informed to resubmit their proposal.
And about the industrial training program, you are following as per ACC now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, industrial training program?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Till in the, your academic calendar?
Yes.
Okay, next is this. About the, this is a recognized research center? This
yes, sir.
This is a
We can have now brief introduction of all the HODs.
Yes.
I just have one observation. I found all the presentation oriented towards engineering. I understand because it's a major engineering institution. But for MBA, it's a little deviated. Maybe we have a summer project. Do you have it in your? I think when we come to MBA, we can show our syllabus and the curriculum of the university. Because they want to see whether you have that internship, summer internship, and the main project. Because that's a little different for MBA. And another thing. Observation is, like I saw there was research in MBA also.
Yes.
And generally for all research work in MBA, we have the structural equation modeling software, AMOS or SPSS. I didn't see that also there. Possibly you showed to me in the MBA department presentation. Possibly.
Okay. Okay, introduce to introduce them, sir.
This is the electronic communication. And Dr. S. Meenakshi Sundar, HRS.
How
yes.
long have you been with this?
2.5 years.
2.5 years.
Yes.
Thank you.
Dr. S. Meenakshi Sundar, Professor in the Department of CS. I am working since 2016 in this college. Total experience is 30 years I have completed service in CT.
Myself, Dr. Parvij Achari, Professor in the Department of Technical Communication Engineering. I am working in this institution since 2015. I am around 16 years of experience.
Department of
Telecommunication.
That is separate?
Yes.
From
but now, in 2019, it is merged with the IEC.
So, otherwise, you have a separate department for ECE, EEE?
Yes.
Yeah.
So, how many departments for electronics?
Electronics, one department. One. Telecommunication separate. Electrical and electronics, that is EEE, that is separate. And then we have electronics and instrumentation and information science and engineering. Six engineering departments. Yes.
So that electronics is there in four departments, but actually.
Yes,
that is
that's
confusion.
What I wanted to know.
Electrical and electronics.
Yeah.
Electronics and communication. Telecommunication
and
engineering.
And you have separate head for each department?
Yes.
There are separate branches.
That is electronics and telecommunication. Then electronics and instrumentation.
You know, you see, they are all 90% of syllabus must be common.
Yes.
And you still have separate head.
That is the requirement also.
For AICT, that is as per the AICT. The courses are recognized under the AICT list.
Okay. So that's why you have to have separate departments.
Myself, Dr. Rashma Bano, Professor and Head Department of Information Science and Engineering, successfully completed 4 years in this institution. Okay, got migrated from other place.
Where were you there?
Actually, I was from Shimoga. So we got admitted into GSSSIETW university. So we migrated from there to here.
No have done a lot of international conferences in the last 4 years. Because yeah, I saw your name. I took it.
Yeah, myself, Kirkman. I'm a board member and CEO. I represent the managing committee also, as well as I work here as the chief executive officer. I've got full time. I've got 30 years of experience total. In that 12 years, I have worked with an industry. I'm basically an electrical engineer from RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. So, I joined this in 2002. So, I'm there. This institution right from the inception. I'm also son-in-law of the founder. Thank you.
Good morning. My Sutra Faraj. So I'm the professor and head of the department. So I'm just 2 months being into this institution. So earlier I used to work in a program. So I have been 5 years in this practice.
Good morning. I am Dr. P.S. Puttaswamy. I am the president of the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering Department. I was there earlier in P.S. College of Engineering in Mandya. I served for 35 years. Recently, I joined here.
This is Dr.
Bellappa,
HOD and the professor of chemistry department. I have been here from 2008. I have got 22 years of experience.
Dr.
Ray,
professor at the Department of Physics. I'm working here since 1 year. I have 10 years of research experience and 9 years of teaching experience.
So myself, Venkat Sesha, head of the Department of Mathematics. I am with the institution since 2003.
Hello everyone, I am Mahadev Prasad, heading Training and Placement Division. It's been 1 year, 3 months working with this institution and I've got 10 years of training and placement experience. Thank you.
Good morning everyone. Myself, Dr. Venkat Ratnam. I am the head of Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering. I have been with GSSSIETW family for the past 2.5 years.
I am Harish Kaur, Physical Education Director, Department of Physical Education and Sports. Last 5 years I am working this institution.
Good morning everyone. Myself Krishna, I am a librarian. I am working since 2003.
Good morning. I am Dr. Ravi Raj, IQAC Director and Professor of Computer Science Engineering Department. I am here from 2017. Totally, I am having 15 years experience.
Good morning. I am Guraj KS, working as an Associate Professor in Computer Science and Engineering. I am a NAAC coordinator and I have been in this institution since 2013.
Myself, Dr. Jain. I am Associate Professor in Electronics and Communication Department and I am working as a NAAC coordinator. So I am in this institution from 2010. My career starts from here.
Can have our own introduction. Yes. I'm Dr. Hansa. I'm from Anna University, Department of Management Studies. I have over 2 decades of experience, but I've been in Anna University for the past 10 years.
I'm Mukul Prakash. I'm founder vice chancellor of Women's Technical University under government of Delhi. And I've also been principal of Girls Engineering College for almost a decade. Presently, I am professor in School of Information Technology in a state university under government of Delhi. And my main area of interest is computer science and engineering. I have around 35 years of experience.
This is Professor S. Chobe. I am a professor of electrical engineering in Rajiv Gandhi Project Vishwavidyalaya with the State Technological University of Madhya Pradesh. I am also dean faculty of electrical engineering RTPV and tech coordinator. The technical education quality improvement program and the extreme coordinator of technology in order to promote quality of technical education in the state.
So I think with this brief introduction of ours, we can now proceed for department. And as a team, we will first go to the library and then we will.
Thank you.
This is for the staff.
No, no, this is for
the staff.
Yes, ma'am.
We are visualizing knowledge dissemination
and we want to develop our girl students as future leaders in information technology with a research program. So we want to see that our students are able to not only learn with the lower order thinking skills, and we want to move them to the higher order thinking skills where they are able to improve their analytical capabilities, evaluation skills and creativity. And our mission is to equip students with the continuous learning process where they are able to acquire knowledge of hardware, software and computation, and they are able to face all challenges which they are able to meet in the industries. And the second mission is to inculcate the core computer science engineering components with discipline among the students to provide, and we are able to provide the best state of art infrastructure, and we are able to ensure that our students are built with utmost discipline so that we get very good feedback from the employers during our NAAC accreditation process. And our third important mission is to impart essential knowledge, wherein we believe in the quality of education and in the value-based education. That is also the motto of the institution itself, value-based education. And we cover the value-based education along with quality. And we build ethical values, leadership qualities, communication skills, and we ensure that
2016 we written the exam, 17 we registered.
Okay, so it was four written exams.
Yes.
And you completed your course work in the first year.
Yes, ma'am.
And the rest of you are not done in?
Yes, ma'am.
So,
nice
working
with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mysuru.
So there is some faculty advisor?
Yes sir, mentor will be there sir for every students.
One mentor will be from the side.
Yes, one external mentor, one internal.
How do you?
We wanted to enhance the industry institute interaction for new technologies like drones, flights, and other things. We wanted to extend the R&D activities in the department. These are the newspaper meetings for the activities we have conducted, like workshops, this is the national conference.
ಸರ್ ಮೇಲ್ ಹೋಯ್ತಾವ್ರೆ
Because they are a network, they are open up.
Ma'am, we are conducting audio boards.
Yes,
sir. So, ma'am.
Thank you.
ಸರ್ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಿಂದೆ
Stand
with
put ready
to turn to session.
Yes, Dr. Mitchell, BTU, last year.
Last year, 2008. Come and do more projects. Pollution control. For old vehicle and all, it will be difficult for monitoring the pollution. So they have just added some module. So based on the emission level, so they to take off the controller, whether it is to what is the next action, alert system and all that. And it has been recognized for industrial thing by the other top company. If anything malfunction is going on, or any leakage. So based on the water level, and we use some gas sensors, so based on that smell, water and all. So this was our first project here, so when we started our IoT lab, so just for Go Green initiative we are doing. And one of some of our students, they have developed for one school now, actually first incident permit. They have developed a second even for that particular and they have recognized and given the small token of submission. Without free of cost, so we have developed a second even for that. We are having 15 audio kits with around 10 to 12 sensors. We have been extending the
from
there one thing technically communication. So temperature and humidity sensors, buttress, and this is MQ2 which will sense the carbon dioxide. Up to 1 kilometer with the line of sight 1 kilometer. If any optical interference, it will be 300 to 500. So we can have multiple nodes like this. So individual, actually this is a client node. So there we are having a master thing. So actually, theoretically it is
2.4 gigahertz or
2.3 gigahertz. We have a sensor there. That will detect only the human system. So remaining at all, just any, if you take your hand or any obstacle or any watch or any object, it will be detected as well. So like we'll be using in Mars sensor, Arjuna Sapara sensor, it will open the door sensor. So that will come for GSS. So remaining obstacle like vehicle, so if vehicle is moving, say any vehicle or any animal, if they come, everything will be detected as well. So two types of obstacles, we are using in the last sensor.
This is to avoid the rainwater. Yes, yes, yes.
Yes,
yes. I've seen it.
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah.
That's why
I put
on
15 kV.
In fact, we are glad actually that first delegate to enter our renovated department. So we are glad actually.
So it's expanded into the. I think it's a very good idea to have these kind of panels separately.
Our ultimate goal is to facilitate the rating of our institution as one of the best technical institutes in India for job listings.
How can they
train
them in GD and interview?
Mm-hmm. Actually, these students are who are placed. Once they are getting placed, they will be the members of the IT club.
Mm-hmm.
They are aware because we conduct the training from second year.
So,
members of NAAC peer team. I hope you are aware of NAAC.
Yes, ma'am.
So we are there for 2 days, today and tomorrow. And we have visited some of the facilities and departments today. Tomorrow also we will be around.
So I am very happy to introduce about the NAAC peer team members. Three members, they came for a NAAC peer team visit for our institution.
Yes, sir. Every year 1 lakh IT consultant pays to
when you are paying 1 lakh rupees.
Collect the requirements and
So his whole course is available.
Yeah.
How many papers do you have in the first semester?
Six papers. So they can take 6 from each specialization, or they can take 3 times?
Yes.
Okay.
So these are 4 specializations.
Okay.
So this is just so
it was supply chain under marketing?
Yeah, actually,
I don't know. So students have taken dual specialization now, they have 4 marketing. Finance marketing and marketing.
So students will take dual specialization.
They take these subjects. But none of them are
offering. Maybe they take supply chain in terms of the logistics and then in terms of
yes,
the extremely
if they take this whole subject, whole study. If they go for dual subject specialization, they will
take for the extreme.
Yeah, supply chain management is a common subject for all these folks.
Okay.
Not only in the world, but in the
specialization. So you have after 2 semesters, you have
internship? Yes.
Third
semester. The third semester. The second semester, they have time for internship.
How many months?
That's for 1 month.
1 month.
It's consistent with the students.
Third semester, do you have to look at the students' interest? Because what university has prescribed
yes.
Yes. So it's you have no hand in that.
No.
So you have to just accept whatever they offer unless you go for the some part of the curriculum development. Yeah. Possibly you don't have operations. No
operations also they are removed from the service.
That's why that is the university is removed.
Yes.
Your
studies now.
What? No idea.
Production operation management.
No, before it was operation management we had that they did. Then operation research was there in 2011. 2012, what they did, like, they merged with VRM and operation research. Then later, they again revised and they combined statistics with OR, some chapters.
Okay,
that's
how it was
there.
So department was established in the year 2006 with the intake of 60. During that particular period, it was a co-education program. So during 2011, we got our intake raised to 120. So in 2017, we made the department as exclusively for women. So earlier to this, it was a co-education program, which was done. Was raised from
2011,
not 70? No, no. 2011, we increased the intake from 60 to 100. 11,
120,
in 2017, the department, yeah.
Actually, previously it was co-ed. Afterwards, we have converted into women's.
Okay. Actually,
previously it was institutions with a different place.
Campus.
Different
campus.
So now we are bringing into the
main campus.
So we wanted to convert into the
So coming to the unique features of the department, we have highly qualified, experienced teachers with a well-stocked library with reputed key journals. So we have spacious classroom as per the ACT norms and modern computer lab with Wi-Fi enabled in each of the floors what we have here. So we conduct outbound program as an extracurricular activity for the students. We conduct this interdisciplinary.
I'd like to say outbound.
Yeah, I'll explain.
Because this is the extra thing that is going to
So we conduct industrial visits on a regular basis to the students. So we encourage
MOOCs are webinar also, I like to see. Outbound MOOCs, webinar and this
stuff.
I would like to see
MOOCs. Vistar is a platform where we provide students to showcase their talents by arranging every week, every Thursday week.
So I analysis. You can tell the industry, this is the construct that makes them dissatisfied. You can tell the marketing people, this is the construct where the sales are not doing well. So that will be a real-time solution for an industry. Then they will grab you for placement. So faculty should get tuned to model building, identifying constructs for the outcome variable, so that you will be able to make the students work on that angle. Okay? So you work on that. That is the only way you can have an impact in the industry to hire your students. And that's also one way for faculty to publish papers. These are the papers that will be published in Scopus and SCA. Okay, so look at it in this angle. Develop. And how many of you read HBR? I know it's a very expensive.
We subscribe to Facebook.
We have.
Every week they'll send you in Facebook. Maybe before the
HBR.
Yes.
HBR, we have cases. You have HBR cases?
Yes.
In Facebook, free of cost?
Yes.
Free, we'll get a
mail. For example, if this week's stories, ma'am. Say, well, like HBR has published that if you're a speaker, if you're presenting something, okay, if you encounter a problem, if the audience are not enough focused towards your presentation, how to overcome those things and all. So they cut
certain things.
Certain things and all that they publish in one or two pages.
Like a few
highlights
they are
sending
it to Facebook for everyone
yes.
To.
Yes, for the
pictures.
Maybe
even
students
also.
That's how we have cases. We have analysis and we have done a video also.
These are the cases from the campus.
No, it's the classroom.
Sound
having your system. Oh, connect
the sir, up and run my laptop connect.
Thank you.
I'm engineer. We are proud to be engineers, and this is last slide I show. These are all the things, whatever you cost, it will be published in media. The newspapers and all of local relevance and state important. At its heart, engineering is about using science to find creative practical solutions. It's a noble profession. We do accept for that. Thank you so much for your question.
All the best, all of you.
Thank you, ma'am. Project lab is different.
Virtual fencing, forest and all that.
Identify and we have identified the first areas which are in what
problems which are villages are facing, and we are giving some solutions to them, and by our students, they are interacting with them, and they are giving some awareness to them, and along with that, we used to be able to get those who are
Moment, those percentage of the students you are ensuring that
100%
no, number of students participating in these activities.
100 students. Actually, 100. University has given guidelines. Actually, we have to take 100 students for one unit. For first, we have only one NSS unit, so that we are involving 100 volunteers. 100
volunteers. No, those who are involved in Namda Bharatan, how many students are going
there?
There
are also 100. Just 100. Actually, 100 students, so we have to take 100 students there. And we used to call for a guest or a resource person who is exporting the data, and we are going to deliver it talk with them.
So have you visited any time with that nearby village?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Village. And you are interacting with those village people?
Yes, sir.
Just give us the food. Regularly fresh vegetables and the greens, everything they eat comes. Daily basis it comes. They order thing. If today night if they order, tomorrow morning by 11 o'clock everything will be here.
Who is going to monitor all these two monitor persons?
Me, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Mutton goes into there, 5 colors. That's wonderful. And there are more than 45 roses are there, sir. Paneer, sir. This is paneer meat. But the flower are there, the garden.
Abhi.
Everything, sir. So all the water, it comes here. Everything. From here, it gets recycled and go for the garden. One is a doctor, and another one, she comes. everybody is having independent discussion. Cupboard, study table, chair, everything.
We are making it 32 floors, making a university. Yeah, we are going to garden
campus.
Becomes one of the best colleges
in the times to come. Because this college has to have a vision for the next 5 to 10 years. And you would like to see, everybody, all the stakeholders would like to see this college progress to the next level. And also be recognized as one of the best colleges in this entire region. So we want to know from you, how was your experience, how your child developed during the days.
Team members, I extend my warm welcome to the NAAC 15 members. So I am Dr. Raviraj, Director of IQAC. I am very happy to present about our IQAC cell activities. So our IQAC cell activities, this is the overview I am going to share about this presentation. First, establishment of IQAC, then our IQAC team members we have comprised, then unique function of IQAC activities, then we periodical meetings about IQAC, and on behalf of IQAC we have conducted some capacity building programs for both students and faculties, then student support and student progression and benchmarks, committees and unis, and our future plan. These are the overview I am going to cover. So I am very happy to introduce about the IQAC establishment day. We have established our internal quality assurance cell in the year 2018, February 2, 2018. So we got UGC 2F and the institutional details also we have. So the main objective of our IQAC is to develop a system for conscious and consistent catalytic action to improve the academic and administrative activities. Then meanwhile, to promote the measure for institutional function towards quality initiatives. So this is the main objectives of our IQAC. This is our team members of IQAC. As per the NAAC standard, we have comprised the IQAC members with the inclusion of internal faculty members and our management members, then principal and myself director, then one student member, one alumni member, and one industry representative. So industry representative, Mr. Harsha Kikeri, he is the CEO of Kayatech. So he is having close association with our institution. So he is the industrial representative. One more, our alumni member is Ms. Girija. She is working in Robert Doe.
Certain events. If the event is already repeated by one of the departments, there is no fun in doing the other department also the same thing. So we propose a different program for them.
As the masters of ceremony of today's event, on behalf of the entire management,
seeks to become one with the eternal dance of the cosmos. Dance is a poem of which each movement
Shakti Rupena Samskita.
So you were rejoicing.
Yeah, rejoicing.
This is the general office, ma'am. And that is accounts.
Ms. Anita, she handles all the personnel issues.
And you guys didn't realize you are making a major contribution to the society.
They're all dedicated and hardworking team, ma'am. They're all the pillars, all of them.
And nominee, you are present. You have DTT nominee, GSCT nominee.
Yes, ma'am. Society is really doing a very good job in terms of providing education to women of this country and giving them opportunity to realize their full dream as well as full potential as technical manpower as joining the workforce of our country. In any case, the women in our workforce are very few, especially in the technical area. Although in IT industry there are 24% employees who are women, but the objective of most of the IT companies is to have 50% participation of women in their workforce. And therefore, in line with the objective and correction of the skewed gender ratio, I am happy that this college is serving the purpose of supplying trained manpower. And the training and placement cell was very impressive facility which has been developed over a period of time with the relationship has been established with so many recruitment companies, and it is very encouraging to see that almost 60% students are getting placed on campus and with almost 30 to 35 companies visiting the campus every year. So this college is doing a great service to the society in terms of educating women in this region, in this part of the country, and giving them a very good, conducive learning environment for engineering education, management education, and I'm sure this college will continue with this good effort. If you look at this new education policy, if you go through the document and the Kasturi Rangan report which has just been launched, every college now will have a mandate to scale them up with the student population of at least 3,000. And there is a very clear-cut mandate
that there will be three types of educational institutions in higher education sector. There will be research universities, there will be teaching universities, and there will be colleges. And colleges will have a minimum enrollment of 3,000 and going up to 5,000. Maximum will be 5,000. And similarly, universities will also have a minimum of 5,000 enrollment, and they will go up to 25,000. And most of the universities should aim towards becoming multidisciplinary in nature. So this is the roadmap that they have carved for the next 10 years for our country, that by 2030, the universities will scale up, and the colleges will also scale up, and they will provide education to underprivileged section of society, people who have not been covered in this drive till date. Because the general enrollment, the gross enrollment ratio of our country as on date is around 25%, which means the population in the age group of 18 to 25, only 25% people are going for higher education. So the mandate of this government is to make the GER 50% by 2030. And that is possible only when the 900 plus universities that we have in our country and more than 45,000 colleges which we have in our country scale up and increase their capacity. So, keeping in line with this vision of higher education, new education policy, this college should also start working in the direction, should also lay down its strategic plan and vision for the next 10 years. And there should be a very clear-cut roadmap as to how you plan to move forward in the times to come, so that you become from 1911, so your present enrollment, in 11-acre campus, you should see what are the norms and you should try to scale up your capacity in the coming times. Probably engineering programs may not be a very good idea to start with, because there is a big saturation coming in this overcapacity and saturation in this field. And therefore, you must have observed that a lot of engineering institutes are not able to fill up their vacancies and their intake is not being filled up. Therefore, you need to think of some interesting courses where girls can be enrolled and you increase your capacity in this very campus in line with the government's vision and in line with the new education policy. So with this, I would like my colleagues who have really helped me out a lot in carrying out this work successfully in the last 2 days and meeting all the deadlines and working late in the night and trying to do things in a timely manner. And I would like my colleagues to also share their experiences, their observations, and if some suggestions come in their mind, they should definitely share with you at this stage. So with this, I would like to request Dr. SCW to say a few words.
Thank you, Madam, for giving a nice words about this institute. And right from beginning, definitely institute deserves a word of appreciation for how much their faculty members are putting efforts in maintaining the academics and passing their instructions to the students. Basically, faculty is the backbone of an institute. And if they are doing their job, means nobody can stop the institute to take off. And every other day, you get instructions from AICT that you have to do this, you have to do this. And institute is following all those instructions. For example, if they are saying that you have to get registered for ICC, yes, institute is registered for ICC. They are saying that you have to develop an incubation center, yes, institute is trying to develop an incubation center, but it is not a one-day job, definitely. But the efforts that institute is putting, definitely it's a good initiatives. Right from beginning, we've seen the first criteria, which is the academic, regarding the curriculum. In fact, the college is has to depend on to follow curriculum laid down by the university. But implementation is really a challenge for the institute. Here, all the teachers are participating in preparing the lesson plan. It is a transparent, it is displayed their website that these are the lecture wise, and 50 lectures will be for completion of one subject, 50 lectures will be elaborated. And the other part is that how to assess the students. I do not say that how the university is assessing our students, but at least we can show that the students should know that how they will be assessed in our internal mid-semester examinations. And that improves the quality of the technical education, that improves the quality of the education. If they know, you know that if they know that they have to read in the day, they have to read in the night to crack this examinations, mid-semester examinations, they will need more. So they do this, and there is a continuous evaluation made by your teachers. That is also a good thing. And every time they are acting as a mentor for the students. Every student, when we interacted with the students, they said, yes, we have got our mentor. Any time I can interact with their mentor, and they are ready to help us. That is a great thing for any institutions, because when their parents send their wards to your custody, you know that, then they do not ask about this, that how their ward is doing, because they have got a lot of, they have a lot of
trust.
They have a lot of trust on you, on the faculty members. They do not say that why our ward is there, how he is doing, whether they are getting the foods or not, but they have got a trust. So that is visible with this institute. The second part is about the teaching learning process. The teaching learning process, naturally, every day it needs improvement. You have to explore a pedagogy, which way we can train our students, because they have to appear in different competitive examinations. Now all the competitive examinations doesn't depend upon the textbook materials. They have to teach us some way, so that our objective is outcome based. You have to ensure they have to crack gate examinations, they have to crack the engineering structure examinations. But you have to think of that, how to teach these students. So that is of course a challenge. And you are following this CO based questions papers, you are following these some visual, audio visual facility you are taking as a support to teach the students. Only that you need to, every day I say that every day you need to learn about how to improve the teaching learning process. So that is also, all of us, that you know, that is always a challenge for our teachers. About the research extension and consultancy, good number of publications are there, published by teachers, faculty members.
And we also thank you all teaching, non-teaching, all everyone, NGW plus.
Thank you very much. It was wonderful, to be interacting with you for the last 2 days. And you come from, far off places like Delhi, Chennai and all that. And I'm glad that, you liked our hospitality and then you liked the place and your appreciation towards the institution. We certainly take your words and take your suggestions. And as you said, we'll not stop at this. We'll continue to improve. And we will certainly see that this college is projected in the national level. Thank you very much.
Then we will meet you and get their appreciation.
We are a national accreditation body.
Yeah.
Yes.
So whenever you are in this part of the state, like Mysore, whenever you are in this site, please do remember us.
Yeah. As a code of conduct for next 1 year, we would request you not to contact us.
I know that, ma'am. I read that in the
at any level or at any forum. But after 1 year, we would definitely.
Certainly.
That is what we have to follow.
Yes, ma'am.
And this report will remain with you, and when the result is declared, then you can open it and share it with other members of your staff. But you have already gone through it. So you are aware of the contents. So thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.